Lisa, I'm sorry to tell you, but you have herpes. When the doctor shared these words, I spiraled inward, shocked, scared, horrified by the life imprisonment I had just been handed. How could this be happening to me? I had been in a marriage for 22 years that I had just left. I was starting a new chapter of my life. I felt amazing, sexy, free. For the first time in my life, I felt beautiful. Outwardly, I was shining. Inwardly, I was filled with fear and loneliness. I desperately was searching for the love and intimacy that was not present in my marriage. I longed for human connection, touch, and affection. Now in my 40s on the dating scene, I felt like a fish out of water. I had no clue how to navigate online dating, but I knew I was ready to be loved. I was easy prey for the first man who was able to feed the attention I had been starving for. I remember the day that I met him. He was elusive. He didn't share very much, and that intrigued me. He seemed vacant, but I just ignored that and forged ahead with the relationship that I wanted to have. Looking back, it makes sense now. His ugly secret turned my life upside down. How was I going to move on from this? How would anybody understand? I shut down. There was going to be no romance for me and no happily ever after. I was flawed, broken. The word herpes sounded filthy and icky. I had a scarlet letter on my heart, and I wallowed in the physical and emotional pain, sinking deeper and deeper. I was supposed to go dancing with my girlfriends. I couldn't go. I had an emotional breakdown. I was ashamed. My heart hurt. I felt empty. My eyes couldn't meet people at eye level. I was failing in my business. I was not showing up for client meetings. This just wasn't me. I found a dating site for people with STIs. The men seemed broken and unhappy. I realized I had to push through the pain and just date regular guys and be okay with that awkward conversation. I started to resent men, dating sites, and dating in general. Self-worth, it had hit rock bottom. What lifted me out of my misery was I started a Live Clean company, and it sparked some passion in me. I was going to change the environment and change the world. I started to focus on networking, entrepreneurship, spirituality, gratitude, and abundance. I started to look inward and become happy and positive. I let love in and started to forgive myself for all the mistakes. Good stuff started to happen. I let go of some of the past and all those emotions of shame. I got them out of my body. I had them sunk deep. It's okay to be human and to make mistakes and to forgive and then to love. We're designed to do this. Every failure got me closer to the best version of me. I found my self-worth. I was able to fill my existence with love. I was brave enough to repair my broken heart. And I found my voice through this journey, strength and truth. My purpose is to speak my truth. Within each and every one of us, we have everything we need when we connect to the self and we do the work. We don't have to stuff the secrets deep down. We can face them head on. Courage is within you. Ask for help. Be open to receive. Forgive. Release. It isn't easy, but it is the road to self-worth.